This news update is brought to you by
with Barbados's largest and fastest 4G network. Activate any Lime prepaid or postpaid mobile plan today.
This is the Barbados Today Evening Update for Tuesday, November the 4th, 2014. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Good evening. Prime Minister Freundel Stuart is this evening in discussions with his CARICOM colleagues, examining critical health issues facing the region. High on the agenda of the one-day summit in Trinidad and Tobago, which began just after 4 p.m., are the potential threat of the deadly Ebola virus and the chikungunya disease. Ministers' responsibility for health, including Barbados' John Boyce and his chief medical officer, Dr. Joyce St. John, as well as representatives from ministries of foreign affairs, are also taking part in the 17th special meeting hosted by Trinidad and Tobago's Prime Minister, Kamla Prasad Bisesar. The Caribbean Public Health Agency, which has taken lead responsibility for the regional response to the diseases, is also taking part. St. Kitts and Nevis Prime Minister Dr. Denzel Douglas, who has responsibility for health in the 15-member CARICOM grouping, is chairing the talks. And the Ministry of Health says the isolation center located at the Enmore Center on Kolomorok will be used for Ebola patients only. Permanent Secretary in the Ministry, Tennyson Springer, said today that a decision had been taken that infectious illnesses which were airborne would not be treated at the facility. Meanwhile, the issue of infectious diseases also dominating the attention of officials at a regional emergency risk communication training workshop at Crane Resort in St. Philip. It is there that Acting Health Minister Donville Innes revealed that the ministry is in the process of developing protocols to prepare for a potential Ebola threat. He says government will also benefit from technical assistance from the Pan American Health Organization when it comes to dealing with infectious diseases.
Further, the ministry is pleased to be a part of the intersectoral committee, which is comprised of representatives from all of the key services which would be required to respond to an outbreak scenario. And this committee has been working to develop a plan of action which will guide the country's response in the event of an importation of a case of Ebola. In this effort, we will benefit from the technical assistance of PAHO, including advisors from the Washington office who will be assisting in an analysis of our plan and an evaluation of protocols and our state of readiness in port health, infection control, clinical management, surveillance, laboratory and intersectoral coordination for emergencies and disasters.
With unemployment on the rise, 40 Barbadians will find work at a new $25 million recycling plant next year. While he could not say how many more will be employed at the construction phase, Managing Director of Bees Recycling, Paul Bino, says town planning permission has just been granted for him to relocate from Cane Garden St. Thomas to Vaucluse in the same parish. Bino, who had been under severe pressure from residents to relocate following a fire at his metal dump in March last year, said this morning he expects construction on the new plant to begin early next year. He said that once it's completed, the additional employees would bring his total to about 160. Bino explained that the proposed new name for his company was Rehoboth Recycling Jays, Inc.
Our next move now is to put finance back in place and try to get our location from Cane Garden here so that we can now expand and set up the equipment that we got sitting down now for a while and try to bring further equipment to separate the different types of material by machine in order to process this material, containerize it and ship it off the island so it can bring, I would consider, viable foreign exchange that the island needs.
The Institute of Chartered Accountants of Barbados says its concerns about the financial state of the National Insurance Scheme remains. On Sunday, Minister of Finance Chris Tinkler assured Barbadians that the fund was sound and that there was no need to worry. However, ICAB's Vice President Andrew Braffitt says his office aired its concerns about the manner in which the fund was being handled. And he says 2 years later, the same issues persist, which government must address.
We do share the concerns about the stability of the National Insurance Fund, especially looking 20, 30 years into the future. There are also concerns about unfunded pensions in the public sector. So there are a number of issues that are not urgent right now, but they're going to very shortly become urgent, and we need to start planning seriously as to how we will address those issues.
There's regional and international news after this short break.
The Barbados Food and Wine and Rum Festival, November 20th to 23rd. Taste the culinary delights of top local and international chefs like Marcus Samuelson, Anne Burrell, Tyler Florence, Roger Mooking, Michael Hines, Dane Sadler, Daphne's Restaurant, and more. The Barbados Food and Wine and Rum Festival, 5th edition, November 20th to 23rd. Visit foodwinerum.com or contact Premier Event Services, Inc. at 435-0670. Get your tickets now at Wine World or Ticket.
Sports Now. West Indies Test captain Dennis Ramden is crying victimization after being axed as the Trinidad and Tobago's Red Force franchise captain for the upcoming regional four-day tournament. Ramden said he was being victimized after being summoned to a meeting where he was told that the Trinidad and Tobago Cricket Board would be moving in a different direction, with all-rounder Riyad Emrit leading the team for the duration of the season. The West Indies captain said he was asked questions about what transpired in India during the meeting with the TTCB, but he said he did not answer those questions on the advice of his lawyer. Ramden was a member of the West Indies team that prematurely ended the recent India tour as a result of a dispute with the West Indies Players Union and the West Indies Cricket Board over their collective bargaining agreement. He, however, remains a member of the Trinidad and Tobago squad. To news from the region, at least six people have reportedly died as heavy rains continue to pound the northern and western sections of Haiti. According to officials from the Departmental Coordination Civil Protection, the rains, which grounded several flights to and from Cape Haitian, caused a house to collapse, killing three children ages 6 to 10. The children's mother was also injured during the incident. Three other people, all adults, lost their lives in the north of the country. Initial reports say that at least 2,000 houses have been flooded and some destroyed. And finally, Mexico police make a major breakthrough in a mass kidnappings case. Lawmen say they have arrested a mayor and his wife, who they suspect plotted the abduction of 43 students. The students have been missing since September the 26th. And that's where we end our Barbados Today evening update. We'll be back again in the morning. But until then, remember to log on to www.barbadostoday.bb. Subscribe to our e-paper and email updates, or like us on Facebook. You can also catch us on Izumi Media in bus terminals or Screenplay at supermarkets and gas stations near you. Also tune in to Channel 101 on Lime TV to get all the latest news and sports. I'm Emmanuel Joseph. Have a great evening.
There's regional and international news after this short break.
The Barbados Food and Wine and Rum Festival, November 20th to 23rd. Taste the culinary delights of top local and international chefs like Marcus Samuelson, Anne Burrell, Tyler Florence, Roger Mooking, Michael Hines, Dane Sadler, Daphne's Restaurant, and more. The Barbados Food and Wine and Rum Festival, 5th edition, November 20th to 23rd. Visit foodwinerum.com or contact Premier Event Services, Inc. at 435-0670. Get your tickets now at Wine World or Ticket. Pal.com.